palace as the place for this municipality, and it is not only going to be a conference, it is going to be an exhibition also. So all the manufacturing company, be it construction sector or urban development sector, solid waste management, different kind of companies, different kind of technology people, they are going and coming here to display their available equipment which is in the market. So this is going to be a large exhibition also, and the theme is that how to make our city a smart and sustainable. We all know in 2015 our honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, he started his one of the dream project called a smart city, and 100 cities we are selected in Karnataka, and this selection was a very unique selection. We have never seen nama deshanalli ondu scheme nalli ಯಾವುದು ನಗರ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಇದು ಒಂದು ಏನು ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯೆ ಅವರು ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದರು ಯಾವುದು ಈ ಸ್ಕೀಮಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೀಷನ್ ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಟಿಯವರು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಯಾರ್ದು ಈ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿತ್ತು ಯಾರ್ದು ಐಡಿಯಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿತ್ತು ಯಾರ್ದು ಸಸ್ಟೈನೇಬಲ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದರು ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ 7 ಸಿಟೀಸ್ ಇನ್ 3 ಫೇಜಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ 7 ಸಿಟಿ ಸಿಕ್ತು ವಿ ಆರ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸೊ ದ ಥೀಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ It started with a smart city, but we have learned a lot in the last 5 years. Be it people at Government of India, be it people at the state level, depending upon the interaction with the citizens, taking their needs into account, what is happening in the international arena, putting all those things together, now we have started talking about not only a smartness, but we are talking about the sustainability of the city. That is equally important, because if the cities are not sustainable, the people are going to face the problem. And then now we have moved one step further. We have also included how to make cities resilient. When we say resilient, it is resilient towards all kind of threat which may be coming to the people living in the urban area. So we are focusing a lot on the climate aspect, how to promote the green building, how to incentivize the reduction of consumption of fossil fuel in the urban transports. You might have seen that Bangalore also, we have started last mile connectivity through the scooter and the bicycle sharing, those things are coming. And then now finally we have added one more element in the whole smart city, that is the livability index of the city. That means the city where you are living, what is your perception about the city? And I would request all of you that the survey is going on, so through you I would like to convey to all the people living in not only in Bangalore but in all the 7 cities, because the Government of India is doing a survey, that how livable is the city. And there is a specific link which they have provided, and we can share that thing later. I will share with you. It must be coming in the newspaper also. So it's a journey which has started in 2015, which was talking only about the smart cities. And initially we thought it's only about an e-governance or the IT initiative, but we have finally come to a situation where everything is included in that. So if you see from that perspective, the theme is very apt for the present condition, that how to make our city a smart and sustainable city. And the best part is that every government department, from the Government of India and the state government, who has a role to play in urban sector, who have a role to play in urban sector, are participating in this program. And I'm very happy to share with you that as of now, because things keep on changing, engagements keep on changing, as of now, our Honorable Chief Minister has agreed to come and inaugurate this program on 12th. Not only Honorable Chief Minister, but our Minister of Urban Development of the Government of India, Hardeep Singh Puri Saab, has also agreed to come and join for this program. But there's only two names. But if you see the list which Mr. Suresh Kumar will brief you, a host of people are coming from the policy making, from the implementation aspect, the experts are coming, the academicians are coming, the new technology people are coming. So the whole idea is to create a forum, to create a forum where the people who are implementing the urban infrastructure, or maybe that housing or poverty alleviation program. When we talk about urban, it is inclusive of each and everything. It's about slum redevelopment, it's about providing the housing to the needy people, employment generation, skill development. Everybody is going to participate in this molecular. So it's a very, very comprehensive workshop, and that's why it is going to be for 3 days, because in one day it is very difficult to cover all these aspects. So like Urban Development Department, Ministry of Energy, Ministry of Environment, both from the state side and the central side, Ministry of Urban Transport, all, everybody is participating in this thing. And we are inviting all our 279. Namma Karnataka Rajyadalli 279 total urban local body, including the city of Bangalore. And we are inviting the elected representative also from those cities, and we are inviting the officials also, because idralli conferential any day a lot of experience sharing is happening. Because sometimes what happens when we are doing something for our city, we feel that we have really done a great thing. But when you go somewhere or somebody comes and tells that, okay, look what I have done in my city, then it becomes a shock for us that, oh, avaru anta olle madidare, naav en madidivi adu aa level ge aa pramanage illa. So it's a good opportunity for my small urban local body from the state perspective to come and be a part of this conference, where a lot of experiences, not only Indian experience but the international experience, are going to be shared. So it's not necessary that everybody will go and suddenly become very efficient in their functioning, but the whole idea is that even if I'm getting 100 people attending here, and even 10 out of them are motivated, that fulfills my reason why I am hosting as a host state, because we have contributed money for this conference from different department, be it BDA, BBMP, BWSSB, in fact all the government department which are working in the urban area, they have all contributed. And only from Karnataka there will be about 1000 delegates coming from 279 urban local bodies, and all the other para estatal agencies, there will be almost about 1000 people who are going to come here. And we are going to discuss all concern of the urban local body, because different size of cities have different problems. So the problem of Shimoga may not be the same as the problem of the Bangalore. So they are going to be a smart city conclave also. In fact, that is the partnership from Government of India, that on 14th, that's the last day, the focus is going to be on a smart city. And not only 7 smart cities, in fact, I understand, I had a discussion with Joint Secretary Government of India, Mr. Kunal Kumar, who is handling the smart city from the Government of India, and he was telling that he is going to motivate every CEO, every MD of a smart city of these 100 cities to come and join for this program. So it's going to be a very, very rich sharing process, and we hope that we'll be able to learn a lot from the experience of the other people. Then it is not only that it's a simple hall where the lectures are going on, because the topics are enormous and it cannot be shared on a single platform or a single dais. So they are going to divide the whole discussion in different halls. So there will be parallel sessions going on, and the people who are coming to attend, they will keep on moving. Like, so if somebody is interested in water supply, he will sit in the water supply part. If somebody is interested in the solid waste management, he will be sitting in the solid waste management. So I will not take much of the time. I'm only try to tell you that it's an exhibition which is going to be of its own type. I don't think in urban sector in Bangalore we have organized this kind of exhibition for last many years. So it's an opportunity for the people of Bangalore and the people of other cities also to come and visit the exhibition. And when they go back to their city, as a citizen, you can participate in your discussion at your ward level and all those places, to bring a pressure on the urban local body to go for these kind of technology which is more useful, more citizen friendly, that kind of thing. And I request all the media people to be present there on that particular day, because you will also come to know a lot of things which are happening in the other cities. Like if you go a city like Surat, they have taken a lot of new initiatives have been taken by Surat. In fact, they are at number one in the smart city implementation, the city number one. Like in a smart city as a state, the government of the state of Karnataka is at seventh rank. Sometimes we go to the sixth rank, because for the top 6-7 slots the fight is very tough. So the point difference is only about 4-5. So sometimes we go up, sometimes some other person will come. So, but there are cities which have done excellent work, like Pune is another city which is doing excellent work as far as the smart initiatives are concerned. So all those CEOs are going to come, they are going to share their experiences, and it will be a good knowledge sharing with you also, because media is the most important pillar today to bring any kind of changes in the planning. So your input is extremely important, and cover as much as possible. Be frank about what you want to write, and whatever you write, whatever is your experiences, we will try to rectify whatever mistakes if it might have happened from our side. So thank you very much, all my friends, for coming here.